So though, you know, the therapists and psychologists will say, try to be impartial and disinterested, it becomes a part and parcel of human life to make comparison, to draw comparison. Interval Balakandam, Ayodhya Kandam and Aranya Kandam doesn't mention of Hanuman at all. You know, when I said, she did not want to stay with him in Lanka. So she... Ramanuja Dayapatram Jnanavairagya Bhushanam Srimad Venkata Natharyam Vande Vedanta Deshikam Lakshminatha Samarambham Nathaya Munamadhyamam Asmadacharya Pariyantam Vande Guru Paramparam Yonityam Achyuta Padambuja Yugmarukma Vyamohata Staditarani Trinayamene Asmad Gurur Bhagavatosya Dayaika Sindhoho Ramanujasya Charano Sharanam Prapadye Mata Pita Yuvatayastanaya Vibhuti Sarvam Yadeva Niyamena Madanvayanam Adhyasyanah Kulapater Vakulabhiramam Srimat Tadangri Yugalam Pranamami Murdhana Bhutam Sarascha Mahadahvaya Bhattanata Shri Bhakti Sara Kulashekhara Yogi Vahan Bhaktangri Renu Parakala Yatindra Mishran Srimat Parankushamunim Pranatosmi Nityam Kujantam Rama Rameti Madhuram Madhuraksharam Aruhya Kavita Shakham Vande Valmiki Kokilam Valmiker Munisimhasya Kavita Vanacharinaha Shrinvan Rama Katha Nadam Konayadi Param Gatim Vedavede Pare Pumsi Jate Dasharathatmaje Vedav Pracheta Sadasid Sakshad Ramayanatmana Anjana Anandanam Viram Janaki Shokanashanam Kapisham Akshahantaram Vande Lanka Bhayankaram Manojavam Marutatulya Vegam Jitendriyam Buddhimatam Varishtam Vatatmajam Vanarayuta Mukhyam Shri Ramadutam Shirasa Namami Anjaneya Madipathalananam Kanchanadrikamaniya Vigraham Parijata Tarumulavasinam Bhavayami Pavamananandanam Yatra Yatra Raghunata Kirtanam Tatra Tatra Kritamasta Kanjalim Bashpavari Paripurna Lochanam Marutim Namata Rakshasantakam. Namasadase. Indeed an honor for me to be in such a August premises, though it is a weak day, your presence has made it strong. And the topic chosen for the day, which is the Upodghatam for my lecture series, I have 22 lectures for 22 days across 8 cities in New Zealand and Australia. And this is the day which is day one. And I'm so happy to begin this lecture, which I was told is immensely blessed by Vayu Bhagavan. With your westerlies and easterlies. And the topic chosen is Vayu Putra Hanuman. So there is a connection between Vayu and his devout son. Srimad Ramayanam happens to be the Mukhya Pramanam, Itihasa Sreshtha. Probably in English too, when we sense a word, we immediately have this habit of making a comparison. Why speak of a word? Even parents who have children, the moment they have more than one, they have two kids, inadvertently they will end up comparing. So though, you know, the therapists and psychologists will say, try to be impartial and disinterested, It becomes a part and parcel of human life to make comparisons, to draw comparisons. You would say, these are my two children. This one studies really well. So, you know what the corollary is. So, it's become a habit to compare. And even the grammar kind of coaxes us to do so. We have the positive degree, the comparative degree, and the superlative degree. So, we always have a good, and there's always something better, and there's always the best. Similarly, in Shastram, when we have two itihasas, which is Srimad Ramayanam and Shri Mahabharatam, acharyas, like parents, have made a comparison and they have said, itihasa sreshtam Srimad Ramayanam. Of the two epics, of the two itihasas that we have bequeathed, that is Srimad Ramayanam and Shri Mahabharatam, Ramayanam is deemed the better. Why? In fact, Mahabharatam should be the better. Bharatav panchamo vedaha jamata dashamograha is a saying in Sanskritam. It seems there are only four Vedas, Rigyajuhu, Sama, Atharvanam. If at all there is a status accorded to the fifth Veda, it has to be Mahabharatam because it houses the quintessence of the first four Vedas. Bharatav panchamo vedaha. So there are only four Vedas. If at all the fifth status has to be accorded to call the fifth Veda, it has to be Mahabharatam. Like there are Navagrahas, and if there is the tenth Graha, it is the son-in-law of the house. Jamata Dashamograha. Why? Because the commentator says, only after the son-in-law comes home, they will realize that the problems given by the first nine is much better. So Jamata Dashamograha. Bharatav panchamo vedaha jamata dashamograha. But despite Sri Mahabharatam housing some of the esoteric works of Sanatana Dharma, like Bhagavad Gita, like Vishnu Sahasranamam, Sri Viduraniti, Yaksha Prashnam, Sanat Sujatiyam, so on and so forth, yet the status which is better of amongst the scriptures is accorded to Ramayanam. Why? Because the way the biographer, who is Valmiki in this case, has narrated seems very unambiguous and linear. Rama was born, Rama married, he went to the forest, his wife was kidnapped, he took efforts to retrieve her. So there is a linearity in the storytelling. Whereas Mahabharatam is tough. It will begin with Shantanu, suddenly it will go to Uttanka, then it will come to Vichitravirya, go to Amba Upakhyana Parvam, then it will talk about Garuda Upakhyana, Vainateya Upakhyana in Adi Parva, then it will go to Yaksha Prashnam, come back again to Udyoga Parva. By the time you end up understanding who are the Pandavas and Kauravas, you will be done with 1,25,000 verses. Sapada Laksha Grantham, it is called. 1,25,000 verses. And trust me, one of the acharyas whom he read, Navalpakam, Ramanujatatachar Swami, who was one of my acharyas, his family members, till about 40 years, memorized the entire 1,25,000 verses. So, you didn't have to go to a folder and retrieve the document to understand and do a control F to understand where the verses, because it was there. So, amongst the two epics, Srimad Ramayanam is deemed the better because for its linearity and narration. In this work called as Srimad Ramayanam, of course the topic chosen for tomorrow is Sri Rama, his Dhamam, which is Ayodhya, and the Rama Janma Bhumi. So that is the topic for tomorrow. So I will speak more about Rama and Srimad Ramayanam tomorrow. Today the topic is Hanuman. But Hanuman is not mutually exclusive with Rama. He is Antargata. He is a subset of Rama. So that said, generally when you narrate or there is a biography, somebody who is very integral to the storyline will be a part and parcel right since its inception, Upodghatam. Hanuman comes only after the interval. He doesn't come before the interval. Balakandam, Ayodhyakandam and Aranyakandam doesn't mention of Hanuman at all. You know, when I say this, you know, some of you may be quite surprised because Chota Bheem and Little Hanuman series on YouTube shows as if Hanuman during his boarding school days met up with Rama. There is no such meeting mentioned in the Ramayanam that I know of, which is done by Valmiki. Maybe the director has been extremely creative. So kudos to him and accolades to his thinking process, but the original Grantham doesn't mention of that. So Hanuman comes only in Kishkindha Kandam. Kishkindha is the current day Karnataka Pradesham, Bellari region, Hampi, Vijayanagara, where they ruled is called Kishkindha. So how do we begin with Hanuman? So where did Rama meet Hanuman? So I have to take you beyond 12,000 verses of Srimad Ramayanam, where Rama, Sita and Lakshmana were in Nashik Panchavati of Maharashtra. We call it Nasik today because there was this widowed sister of Ravana called Shurpanakha. So Shurpanakha. Nakha shabdam means nail. Shurpa means which is the winnowing fan. So generally when you get rice in your house, it undergoes various stages. There is a husk with the grain. So when you pound it, the husk gets separated from the grain. How do we literally separate? So there used to be many, many fans where you put the husk and the rice together and then you do this and the lighter husk runs away from the grain. This fan which is used for winnowing is called Shurpa in Sanskritam. Shurpanakha means once one whose nails wouldn't grow straight, it would grow sideways. Shurpanakha. Whenever I used to read this verse in Sanskritam, I used to wonder, how is this even possible? While I was in Bombay for some time working for the Tatas, my roommate was from Coimbatore. And once every 3 months, he would have a surgical procedure done on his nails. Because for him, there was a problem where the nails wouldn't grow straight. It would grow sideways, breaking his skin. So every 3 months, he had to go and take the nails, complete nail off. So it is a small genetic problem. And that existed in Shurpanakha. So Shurpanakha was a widowed sister to Ravana. Since she was widowed by her very own brother, she did not want to stay with him in Lanka. So she came to Janasthana, the current day Nagpur in Maharashtra. And she was staying with her half-brothers called Kara, Dushana and Trishiras. They were the half-brothers. Kara, Dushana and Trishiras. Trishiras was performing penance on a hillock which is very close to the waters of Kaveri in Tamil Nadu. Since this hillock where Trishiras, the Rakshasa, sat and performed penance, this place was called Trishiragiri. Trishiras performed penance over this giri. Giri is mountain. Trishiragiri. Trishiragiri became Tiruchirappalli, which is Trichy today in Tamil Nadu. Shri Matri Bhutam Trishira Girinatham Hridi Sugandhi Kuntalamba Sametam. Shri Matri Bhutam. Matri Bhutam in Tamil means Tayum Anavar. So that place is called Trishira Giri. So she was housed in Janasthanam. She goes on a sojourn to Nashik. She is enamored by Rama's beauty. Apada Paryantam. Akesha Padam. Padadikesham. Rama was a personification of flawless, blemishless beauty. Tyagaraja, the very well known poet in the Telugu tradition, says, Lavanya Telugu Varunara Ikkada. Lavanya Ramara Larajudare Ati Lavanya. Lavanya Ramara Larajudare. So why don't you come and see Lavanya Rama? Samskrita Bhasha lo Lavanya Shabdamiki emi artham? Lavanya mante? Beauty. Saundarya mante? Beauty. Ennanna idu. Saundarya nala beauty, Lavanyam nala beauty. See in Samskritam, Saundaryam means avayava shobha. That's the definition. Part by part, if somebody is beautiful, it is called Saundaryam. Overall beauty is called Lavanyam. Tamil kar alkaalenge? Kalyanathukku ponomnu vechunga. பொண்ணு எப்படி இருந்தா துரகேன்னு பார்க்கறதுக்கு நல்லா இருந்தா. யூனோ, வென் யூ ஆஸ்க் ஹவ் த பிரைட் ஆஃப் த க்ரூம் இஸ், ஓ ஃப்ரம் அ டிஸ்டன்ஸ் தேவர் லுக்கிங் குட், விச் மீன்ஸ் லாவண்ய சோபா, ஓவரால் தே ஆர் குட். பொண்ணு பார்க்கறதுக்கு எப்படி இருக்கா, மூக்கு கிளி கிளி மாதிரி இருக்குது, மூக்கு மூக்கு மட்டும்தான் நல்லா இருக்குதுன்னு அர்த்தம், மூக்கையே தான் பார்த்துட்டு இருக்கணும். ஸோ தென் தட் இஸ் கால்ட் சௌந்தர்யம். ஸோ ஹவ் வாஸ் ராமா? போத் சௌந்தர்யம் அண்ட் லாவண்யம், அவயவ சோபா அண்ட் சமுதாய சோபா வேர் இன் ஹிம். So Shurpanakha was enamored by Rama's beauty. She went and proposed. A lot more can happen over a cup of coffee, Rama. She drew a heart with cinnamon powder at the top. And she said, I love you. And Rama said, see, in the next avataram had you proposed, this wouldn't have been rejected. In Krishna avataram, no application went rejected. You have come and proposed to me in Rama avataram. See, in this avataram, I have promised, I have vowed to be Ekapatni Vrata. Just with one Dara. In Krishna Avataram, if Shurpanakha had proposed, we will be like Radha Kalyanam, Rukmini Kalyanam, we will be celebrating even Shurpanakha Kalyanam. So you've proposed to me in Rama Avataram, not possible. And then she goes and proposes to Lakshmana. And Lakshmana said, see, I am already entrusted with the work of washing utensils in their house. If you marry me, you will get your fair share of washing. Do you want to do the dishes? Then she was loitering between the two. She found Sita. She wanted to attack Sita. Then Lakshmana chops her nose. She goes and complains to her half-brothers. Then they come as a number of 14,000 in Janasthana. And Ekascharamo Dharmatma Katham Yuddham Bhavishyati, says Valmiki. And Rama with his valor, Asahaya Shura, Anapaya Sahasa, with no help from anybody, he was able to vanquish 13,999 demons in Janasthana. The one remaining called Akampana goes and describes the valor of Rama, while Shurpanakha describes the beauty of Sita to Ravana in Lanka, and he seeks the help of his uncle called Maricha, who comes as a disguise of a gem-studded golden deer, and Rama goes behind the deer, and when the war cry comes and the help comes, then Sita dispatches Lakshmana. Lakshmana leaves that place drawing what Rekha? There is no mention of Lakshman Rekha in Srimad Ramayana. That is why I asked. In India, for cockroaches, you get one. Have you heard of that? It is called Lakshman Rekha. That is the only Rekha we know. In Ramayanam, there is no Lakshman Rekha. See, the beauty is, what is famous in Ramayanam is what is not there in Ramayanam. One Lakshman Rekha, Shabari biting and giving, all this is not there. See, basic hygiene. Why will she bite and give, and how will Rama consume? Correct? Even people with less orthodoxy like us, we will not end up consuming somebody's remaining portion of an apple. How will Rama, Achara Shila, Dharmo Vigrahavan Dharmaha, how will he consume the remaining berries of Shabari? Shabari is an age-old woman. She'll come with little maturity. Why will she bite and give? So all this is not there in Ramayanam. I'm being very blunt because this is Mukhya Pramana. Or you have to show me that verse in Ramayanam. No, sir. Fact check, like India Today I'm doing. Dekhe either. You should tell me. It is not there. Now, when Lakshmana leaves, he tells, let the flora and the fauna protect you. And that is when a scavenger, a bird called as Jatayu, listens, and that tries protecting Sita, because Ravana has come in the disguise of a Parivrajaka, as an ascetic, a sannyasi. He abducts Sita. And when Sita is abducted, she cries for help, bachao, bachao. You will know all those scenes, you're done. So then after giving moksham to Jatayu, Tyagaraja says, Mruga madalalama shubhanitil varajatayu moksha paladapavamana. Kuresha, the great poet, says, Akshunya yoga pathamagrahyatam jatayum tiryanchameva bhavatam. So Jatayu is given moksham. Then Shabari's moksham was witnessed by Rama. Rama did not grant moksham to Shabari. Shabari moksha sakshi bhuta. She was like the ajivikas in those days. She was a shramani. She enters the blazing fire. And then after that, from Maharashtra, he enters the current day Karnataka Pradesham. Kannada da uridara illi? Kannada artha agutta? So Karnataka Deshadalli, you've got this Bellari region. So he enters. This is where Hanuman's role begins. So till now we had no Hanuman. So Rama is in a very, very tough position of his life, where he is without Sita, he doesn't know where Sita is, in which direction Lanka is. That is when Hanuman comes into picture. Now, as Rama and Lakshmana walk into Kishkindha, those of you who have had the opportunity to visit incredible India, please visit Hampi. It is a UNESCO site. It is roughly about 500 years back that the Vijayanagara kings developed this beautiful city. We had great kings like Krishna Devaraya, Achyuta Devaraya, and so on. So they went to Kishkindha. As these two men entered Kishkindha, Rama was extremely dark. See, when we speak about Rama as per Ramayanam, Agratav Prayayu Ramaha Sita Madhyesu Madhyama Prishtatastu Dhanushpanihi Lakshmanaha Anujagamaha. Extremely dark. If you keep the collyrium next to him, you wouldn't know which one is darker. Because he was as dark as collyrium, pure black. Lakshmana was extremely fair. So it was like a chessboard. So both of them entered Kishkindha Rajyam. That is when Sugriva, the excommunicated brother of Vali, was housed in the cave of Rishyamukha Parvatam. So he told his minister, advisor, whatever you call it, consultant, called as Hanuman. Hanuman, you go and check who these two gym-bodied men are. Very well built they are. Maybe my brother has dispatched the two of them to annihilate me. So Hanuman had to go. But Hanuman had a big problem. See, Hanuman was an educated vanara. He spoke in Sanskritam. And imagine you go to a zoo or a national park, assuming that these animals are of lesser caliber than us. And there suddenly comes one gorilla and starts reciting Aditya Hridayam. Tato yuddha parishrantam samare chintayasthitam. Gorilla recites. Now we will be wondering whether we should be in the cage and gorilla should be wandering around. That has flawless Sanskritam. Tato yuddha parishrantam samare chintayasthitam. So Hanuman was an anavavyakarana pandita, extremely adept in speaking. So he was worried. As an educated, well-spoken monkey, he goes and stands before Rama. What will Rama think? So he took 2 hours to disguise himself as a Brahmana. He put some foundation here and there, eyeshadow. Then put that, tied one rubber band to his tail, inserted that within his Angavastram. He had to disguise himself as a normal human being. So he approaches, he walks towards Rama and introduces himself. Sugriva Sachivo Nama Hanuman Nama Vanaraha. I am the consultant minister to Sugriva. I am a Vanara by name Hanuman. 2 hours of makeup waste. See, 2 hours he has spent on his makeup to only mask his identity of being a Vanara. He says, Sugriva Sachivo Nama Hanuman Nama Vanaraha. The commentator to Ramayana asks, why did Hanuman have to reveal his identity? To which he says, when one stands in front of the Supreme Paramatma, you will never have the intent to lie. You can never lie. Vishnu Sahasranamam says, Avyayaha Purushaha Sakshi. The one who you think is outside in the temple is actually within you. He is witness to everything that you think and do. So generally, you know, we have this habit here. But generally I'm telling you, if I have to discard a paper and I don't find a dustbin around, but I want to get rid of the paper, first I will look if there's somebody left, somebody right, and throw it. Unaware of the fact that there is somebody watching me from within. Avyayaha Purushaha Sakshi. Says Vishnu Sahasranamam. He Sakshi, witness to everything that we think and do. So Hanuman, he goes and says, Sugriva Sachivo Nama Hanuman Nama Vanaraha. Then he looks at the two of them. He says, Ayatascha Suvrittascha Bahavaha Parigopamaha Sarvabhushana Bhusharhaha Kimarthamna Vibhushitaha. So he speaks 3-4 sentences in Sanskritam, flawless Sanskritam, before the two men. Rama and Lakshmana listen to Hanuman's short speech patiently. And after having listened to Hanuman's speech, Rama turns towards Lakshmana and says, Lakshmana, in my 39th year now, because when Rama was married, he was running his 11th year. Sita was 6. They lived happily in Ayodhya for 12 years. So on the beginning of the 25th year, because he was told to go to the forest, on his birthday, Chaitramasam Punarvasu Nakshatram, 25th year when he turned, there was an announcement that he had to go to the forest. So Chaitra Pushyam he left. So 14 years, till the 13th year, there was no problem. Everything was very, very fine. The 14th year is when they start experiencing problems such as kidnapping of Sita and so on and so forth. So he says, till now, Lakshmana, I have never come across a person who is as adept and eloquent as Hanuman. He gives 10 sentences, you know, of course, as a part of our syllabus, disciplinary courses in MBA, in the second and the third semester, we will have negotiation skills, organizational behavior and all. There will be something called communication skills. This is free course, communication skills. He tells 10 verses. Read those 10 verses. It's called Bhashana Kaushalam in Valmiki Ramayanam. He says, Nanrigveda Vinitasya Nayajurveda Dharinaha Nasamaveda Vidushaha Shakyamevam Prabhashitum Nunam Vyakaranam Kritsnam Anena Bahudhashrutam Bahuvyaharatanena Nakinchi Tapashabditam Avistaram Asandigdham Adhritam Avilambitam Urastham Kantakam Vakyam Vartate Madhyamesvare Samskara Kramasampanna Mudhritam Avilambitam Ucharayati Kalyanim Vacham Hridaya Harinim. Each verse, Rama describes Hanuman's communication skills to Lakshmana. He said, Na anrigveda viditasya. So if you learn and master the Rigveda, what will you get in return? Vinitasya, you will get humility. Rama tells Lakshmana, even a person who has mastered the Rigveda and is supposed to bequeath humility cannot match the humility of Hanuman. Na anrigveda vinitasya. Na ayajurveda dharinaha. When you master yajurveda, you get dharana shakti, remembrance. See, the beauty about Sanatana Dharma is, very late in our civilization only, we had manuscripts. Earlier civilization was about shruti, listening, and smriti, remembering. You should not have a manuscript. You should not have a script. You should remember, if you tell, where is Ajayamano Bahudha Vijayate, I should tell in Taitreya, in Yajurvedam, in Krishna Yajurvedam, in Taitreya Aranyakam, in the third passage, this line comes. That is the remembrance that one should have. So, na ayajurveda dharinaha, even a person who has mastered the Yajurveda and who has learnt the art of memory cannot match this man. Na ayajurveda dharinaha. Na samaveda vidushaha shakyamevam prabhashitum. Even a person who has mastered the samaveda and is supposed to be called a scholar, vidwan, cannot match Hanuman's scholarliness, scholastic achievements. Avistaram asandigdham adhritam avilambitam. He says, when you speak, you should not be very fast. Avistaram asandigdham. You should not be very slow. Aaj upasthit. When will you complete in this space? So it should be spaced well. Avistaram asandigdham adhritam avilambitam. It should not be dragged. Urastam kantakam vakyam. So we have, there are four stages of speech, says Shastram. Para, Pashyanti, Madhyama, Vaikari. These are the four stages. That is why Muthuswami Dikshitar says, Paradi chatvari vagatmaka pranava swarupa vakritundam. Paradi chatvari vagatmaka. When a word comes, we don't realize it undergoes so much of process. Tyagaraja says, Nabhi hrutkantha rasanana sadu lillo shobillo saptaswara. So in Lalita Sahasranamam you get para pashyanti kshiti rupa pashyanti paradevata madhyama vaikari rupa bhaktamanasa hamsika. So you've got these four stages. So when the word emerges, it has to come in a certain pace. So Rama says, look at the way this man speaks. It is as per what is given in the textbook.
There is not a single deviation from what is said. That is Hanuman's eloquence. Samskara kramasampannam adhrutam avilambitam uccharayati kalyani. When you're given a mic, you should not shout. Neither should it be baritone. Where will you go see Bali Chakravarti and come? So it should not be very deep. It should not be shouting. It should be at a pace where everyone listens. Vartate madhyame svare. So all these points, have an eye contact, use your hands, look at everybody. So all this Rama tells to Lakshmana looking at Hanuman's speech. Now in return, what should Hanuman ask? Imagine I was in Hanuman's place. Hello sir, you seem very sad. Where is your wife? Kidnapped. Who kidnapped? I would have, you know, even if Rama was not crying at that point in time, I will coax him to cry, shed tears. Bas roye, kuch nahi, abhi, no, therapists say you should always cry, you cry. I would have made him cry. Had I been in Hanuman's position, that is why I was not in Hanuman, that is why Punarapi Jananam, Punarapi Maranam, I am now in Wellington. Had I been Hanuman, I would have got moksham then and would have gone to Vaikuntham. Why? How did Hanuman know that Rama's wife is kidnapped? Because Rama should tell Hanuman, I was married to Sita, both of us lived a happy life, we came to the forest, my wife was kidnapped one particular day. Something he should tell. Or none of this Rama divulged. How? Because even in our attire, in the early tradition of Sanatana Dharma, we had this concept of telling another person, indicating the person who's opposite me that I'm married or not. So only when I cross the stage of Brahmacharya, do Samavartanam, I have a Vedic graduation, then I have Samavartanam, I will be allowed to wear the dhoti in this format. It is called Kacham. You have many folds. In five places you fold. So it's called Pancha Kacham. So in five places it has to be done. So a married man can only put this. Of course, Manyavar stitches for everyone today. But this can be worn by married men. So when Rama was wearing a kacham, it literally meant he was married. But he could have been married and yet a widower. Correct. You can be married, but your wife could be dead. His wife could not have been dead because only if you are married and you are not a widower, you are allowed to perform any activity related to the fire. You can cook or you can do yajnam, agnihotram, only if your wife is alive. So Rama was holding the stick with the fire burning, which indicated that he is married because of kacham and his wife is not dead because of fire. Well, his wife could be somewhere in the forest. No, because his face showed melancholy in it. So Hanuman recognized that this man is married, yet he is doing agnihotram. Why is he doing agnihotram? Because his wife is not dead. And at the same time, his wife must be kidnapped. Thereby, it is clearly showcased that his wife has been kidnapped. So Hanuman deciphered all of this without a single word of being divulged by Rama. That is why he is called Navavyakarana Pandita. A man who has mastered the nuances of grammar. So Hanuman, what he does is, he says, Rama, Lakshmana, please come to our Rishyamukha Parvatam. I will introduce you to Sugriva. So they take. Now imagine on the other hand, Sugriva is not as polished as Hanuman. Where is your wife? First question in Kishkindha Kandam. Kidnapped. Even my wife is kidnapped. See, in vulnerable times, you need to make coalition with unequal partners. So Rama had one such time. So he said, what do we do now? Sugriva said, you help me, I will help you. Simple dealing. So that is when the dealing was, I will help you rescue your wife Ruma from the clutches of your brother Vali. In return, you have to help in rescuing my wife wherever she is, because we do not know the exact coordinates, with the help of your Vanara Sainyam. Deal done. Sita Kapindra Kshanada Charanam Rajiva Hemo Jvalanopamani Sugriva Rama Pranaya Prasange Vamani Netrani Samam Spuranti. Sugriva and Rama. Sita Kapindra Kshanada Charanam they went around the fire. That was the memorandum of understanding in those days. MOU means today I'm at the right place. How do you exchange between countries? You give those documents and have a photo, right? So in those days, you had to go around the fire. I rescue your wife, you rescue my wife. Done. And then Vali was killed. I'm not getting into the details because I have to concentrate on Hanuman. Vali was killed. Sugriva was made the king. For 4 full months, he said, my monkeys cannot go in search because it is Chaturmasya, monsoon season. And they will get sinus problem. So I will not ask them to go for in search of Sita. After 4 months, they will come. After 4 months, he did not come. Promise given, but not fulfilled. So that is when Rama dispatches Lakshmana and says, go tell that wretched brother of Vali, who's by name Sugriva, that I had once opened the door to his brother Vali and I have not closed that door. Go tell him that. So the moment he rushes, Vali's wife Sugriva was remarried to, Vali's wife Tara was remarried to Sugriva. So, Sapraskhalanti, Madavihvalakshim, Pralamba, Kanchi, Guna, Hemasutram, Salakshana, Lakshmana Sannidhanam, Jagamatara, Namitanga Yashtihi, she comes. And she asks, why do you get angry, Lakshmana? You should not get angry like this. Haven't you heard in your moral science lesson, anger is bad for health? Kimkopamulam Manujendra Putra, aisa nahi kar sakte ho. So then he dispatches various vanaras in different directions. So if you go through Kishkindha Kandam of Ramayanam, you will also understand the geography very well. Because he says, as you go east, Yavadvipe Samipe, you will cause Yavadvipam. In Sanskritam, Ya, Ja are replaceable. In Vedam, in the south of India, we say Yasmai. Whereas if you go slightly to parts of North India, you'll say Jasmai. That's why Yamuna becomes Jamuna. Jamuna ke nare. So, ya ja is replaceable. So, Sugriva says, yavadvipe, yavadvipe. Ya is ja. So, javadvipe is Java. So, you have the western part of the archipelago nation, Indonesia, which is Java. Then he says, you will find people who have not grown that much. So, you had such species, human species who had not grown very much. And they were called Valakhilyas in those days. And then he goes till the place where Atris, the Atreyas, the descendants of Atri Maharishi, see the sun for the first time. So it comes along the line of the Fiji Islands. So there, in between that, you will see the place where Garuda is, that species is. It's called the Brahmana eagle today. Brahman eagle, you call it, that species. So he describes the geography of east and west. He goes till Turkey. And then he says, you have to go south. This is where Hanuman's role begins. Because Hanuman is dispatched in the team that goes south. He has heard that she could be, Lanka could be in south. So he sends Hanuman along with the other Vanaras to the southern direction. So from Kishkindha, which is Karnataka, you have to come all the way till the tip of Tamil Nadu, the state. So all these Vanaras have come. Now they were not able to find Sita anywhere on their path. So they all planned to commit suicide, mass suicide. So that is when they were ready, they started telling, how bad is our time? Rama has helped us, but we were not able to help Rama. That is when one scavenger is said to have recognized and through body language was able to communicate something that a few Vanaras were able to decipher. This scavenger was the elder brother to Jatayu called Sampati. Sampati Sampati Vakya Protirna Nodinagdi Nagari Janakajam Vikshadatwanguliyam Pradyudyudyanam Akshapana Chanarana Shodabando Dashasyam Drishtva Prushtva Chalankam Jatiti Sahanuman Mauliratnam Dadaute says Narayana Bhattadri Narayaniyam. So this bird called as Sampati says that my son Suparshva has seen a lady cry and being forcefully taken in the southern direction. So you go in the southern direction. That is when comes a discussion. How many of you can go to Lanka without passport and visa? How many of you can go? That is when one Vanara says, I can go 10 yojanas. The other one says 20 yojanas. The other one says 30 yojanas. But it was way beyond that. Finally, Jambavan. He knew that Hanuman had the ability to go till Lanka. But Hanuman was quiet. Why? There is a flashback to Hanuman's past. What is it? Now, we had an Apsara Stree. The Apsara Stri was called as Tilottama. And there was another Apsara Stri called Punjikasthala, a dancer. So this Punjikasthala was in love with the Abhimanini Devata of Vayu. And while they were in one of the water theme parks in India, they managed to splash some water on a rishi. The rishi said, since you are doing acts like that of a monkey, you will be born as a monkey. And she was born as a monkey called Anjana. And it is also said that many of the estranged kings during the times of Parashurama, to escape Parashurama's wrath, they disguised themselves as monkeys and lived in the forest. We have an inscription of the Chalukya dynasty too. So as they were married, this man was treated like the lion amongst the monkeys. He was called Kesari. Kesari and Anjana, they were married. And they wanted a child. They prayed to Rudra, Rudramurti, Mahadeva, Shiva. And as an amsham of Shiva, with the help of Vayu, Anjana gave birth to a beautiful son. Why am I using the word beautiful? Because to every mother, the daughter or the son is extremely beautiful. In Tamil, there is a saying, Kakkaikum Tankunju Punkunju. So for every mother, their daughter or son is that Miss World, Miss Universe, pageant title holder. So they are extremely beautiful. But Hanuman was extremely beautiful. So what was his original name? As per Shastram, his original name was Sundara. That is why the Kandam itself is called Sundara Kandam. Sundara. Sundare Sundari Sita. Sundare Sundari Katha. Sundare Sundari Lanka. Sundare Kimna Sundaram. Sundare Sundari Sita. Akshata Marute Mukhat. Shrutva Hrishtaha Tathaivastu. Saramaha Satatam Hridi. The commentator Nagesha Bhatta tells, in Sundara Kandam, what is not beautiful? The one who has sent the message, Rama, is Sundara Rama. Sundara Dasharatha Nandana Rama. Extremely beautiful. Tulasidas says, Navakanja Lochana Kanja Pada Mukha Kanja Pada Kanja Runam Shri Rama Chandra Kripalu Bhajomana Harana Bhava Bhaya Darunam Kanja. See, when Shastram describes the Lord, it says that the eyes of the Lord are akin to the petals of a newly blossomed lotus. Everything should be correct. Gambhiramba samudbhuta sumrishtanala ravikara vikasita pundarikadala amala ayate kshanaha. In Shastram, you have to describe the eyes this way. You should not say beautiful eyes. Gambhiramba samudbhuta sumrishtanala ravikara vikasita pundarikadala amala ayate kshanaha. When the rays of the sun touch the bud of a lotus flower with a long stalk in the serene waters of the Hutt River. What river? Hutt River. So the rays have to open the petals of the lotus, and if you take a petal out of that lotus, that will resemble the eyes of the Lord. So every part of his has to be akin to the lotus. Now, that said, here it is said that Rama was extremely handsome. Sundara Rama. So he is the one who is sending the message. To whom is the message sent? To Sita. Hantarastamasa mudanti kamale danta mudam tavakaha, says the Sanskrit poet. He says, how beautiful are her teeth. Narayana Bhattadri in another poem says, unmila danta pankti spuratarunatara chaye bimbadarantaha. So when Krishna laughs in Guruvayur, when he smiles, you can see unmila danta pankti. Dantam is teeth. Pankti, the row of teeth. How beautiful are they? In fact, I had been to one of the parties while I was working. We had a sales meet and my friend and I went to the party. And as we were seated collecting our plates,
eating, we had a lady, extremely pretty, with great charisma. She was seated in front and she was smiling. And not at me, at my friend. So, and my friend was extremely proud of the gesture that she was offering. And as she was smiling, he too smiled back. And as he smiled, she too smiled. And she walked all the way till the both of us, and she spoke to him and she said, "Come and meet me." He said, "Sure, and where?" She said, "At my dental clinic." "While you smile, I just observed that your teeth needs correction." So, unmeela danta pankti spura taruna tarachhaya bimbadarantaha. When the Lord smiles, it is flawless smile. But the poet says, when Sita, she used to nurture a parrot. And the parrot used to sit on her fingers. See, why am I using this? Because in Natya Shastram, there is a mudra for everything. So, you know, when I was asked to speak on the TV channels about Ram Lalla of Ayodhya, initially, just a few seconds, the moment I saw the picture, it took little time for me to gather some information and speak. Just a few seconds. Why? Because traditionally when we do Rama Vigraham, we don't make it straight. We make it in Tribhangam. That's called Shastram. In Natya Shastram, you cannot stand like this. You have to bend one foot this way, then bend your knee on one side, tilt your hip on one side, and it's called Tribhangam. Rama will generally stand in Tribhangam. Why? Because Valmiki Ramayanam says, Vaiharikaha. Rama was very adept in dance. Extremely adept in dance. This is mentioned as one of the quality in Ayodhya Kandam. But maybe he was very shy to dance in public. He would dance only to Sita. That could be true. But, so Ram Lalla is a nationalist. National anthem. So he stands straight. Right, he's in national anthem pose. So it took little time for me. And then I described, no, in Shastram there is a way where you can stand straight. Now coming to the point. So Sita was extremely pretty. So she used to have this mudra. This is the place where you hold the parrot. So the parrot which she nurtured was extremely attached to her. And when she used to smile, the poet says, Hantaras tamasa mudanti kamale danta mudam tavakaha. The red hue on her lips used to reflect on her white teeth. And for a moment, the white teeth used to resemble the seeds of a pomegranate fruit. And the parrot used to think that this pomegranate, so let me prick and see. So Sita used to say, don't go there, this is my teeth and not pomegranate seeds. As she used to move her hand this way and that way, the bangles went hither and thither and made her skin red, it seems. Hantaras tamasa mudanti kamale danta mudam tavakaha. So her beauty, she is described as a personification of beauty. So the message is sent by Rama, who's Sundara, to Sita, who's a Sundari. And where is Sita housed in Lanka? How is Lanka Sundara? Who carries the message? Hanuman, whose original name is Sundara. So that is why the Kandam itself is called Sundara Kandam, says the poet. Now, what Sundara was he? He was Kesundar, because his father was Kesari. Right, so he was Kesundar. We don't have problems with Kesundar. We have problems only with Enram. So here, this Sundara was extremely pretty. So he had to carry the message. But Jambavan comes and tells Hanuman, you have the energy to go. He asks, why don't I know of it? Because while you were very young, since you were bestowed with the power of Vayu, you were able to jump much, much better than most other Vanaras. When your mother was feeding curd rice to you. I'll tell you on a lighter vein. I was telling this in Vasant Vihar in Delhi. I was having a Navaham in a temple. The audience got extremely disturbed. Ye kya hai sir, aap Madrasi ho. Isliye you're telling curd rice. Why? Hanuman could have had chapati, right? So I said, there is no question of gluten allergy or anything. He could have had chapati, but Puranam says masrila kabalam. Masrila kabalam means curd rice. So he had curd rice. What can I do for that? Even in Srimad Bhagavatam, there is a verse for Krishna. Bibhradvenum jatarapathaya shrungavetye chakakshe vame paano masrila kabalam tatphalamangyulishu. Shukabrumam says, on his left hand, Krishna was having curd rice balls. On the right hand side, he was having pickle. And he was having.
Now he again they asked, why was there no wheat? Wheat was there. Because in Chamakam in Vedam, we says Goduma Chame. There is a Chamakam which says Goduma Chame. Wheat existed, but we don't know if it was consumed every day. So now let's get back. So Hanuman was given curd rice. Along with curd rice, some people have the habit of consuming mangoes. In Mumbai, you get one variety called Apus or Alfonsa. If you look at that, your sugar will be 8.5 HbA1c. Just looking. Eating, you'll get moksham. Looking, your HbA1c will be that. So you have to completely do Sharanagati to metformin and glimepiride combination. Now, here, Hanuman was being fed with curd rice. Now, there was no mango supply that day. Right? Even frozen mangoes were not available. Now, what to do? That is when he looked at the rising sun in the morning. Udikkindra sengadir uchittilagam. When the sun rises with a red hue, it looks resembles the mango. So that is why the Telugu poet Annamaya says, Balarka bimbamu phalamani batina alari chetala hanumanta dunari brahma dulache varamulu uli chekoni na vo hanumanta mangambudi hanumanta. తెలుగు భాషలో బాలార్క బింబము, అర్కము అంటే సూర్యుడు, బాలార్కము రైజింగ్ సన్, ఫలమని పట్టి, హీ థాట్ ఇట్ టు బీ అ ఫ్రూట్. యాజ్ హీ వాజ్ జంపింగ్ ట్రీ ఆఫ్టర్ ట్రీ, అవర్ ఇంద్ర పొజిషన్ పవర్ పర్సన్, హీ థాట్ హనుమాన్ ఇస్ కమింగ్ ఫర్ ఇస్ థ్రోన్. హీ టుక్ ద వజ్రాయుధం అండ్ స్ట్రక్ హను. హను ఇస్ దిస్ పోర్షన్, దిస్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ హను, దిస్ లోవర్ జా, దిస్ పోర్షన్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ హను. సో వెన్ హను వాజ్ హిట్, he fell. And as Hanuman, now rightfully not Hanuman, K. Sundar fell. When K. Sundar fell, Vayu got upset. He reduced the proportion of his oxygen composition from 20.08 to 19. Immediately people had a lot of breathing problems. That is when all the devatas come and request Vayu, please save us from dying and we will give energy to this boy. And Brahma came and everybody gave energy and this boy was able to recover very fast. Since his Hanu was hit, he was called Hanuman. Hanu Shabdam Idam. This is Hanu. So he was called Hanuman. Since he was the son of Anjana Devi, he was called Anjaneya. And his original name was Kesundar. Now, everyone tries to impress upon Anjana Devi. And they say, we will give one boon. Finally, Surya Bhagavan was standing in that line. I don't know if you remember those days in the school. Teacher will ask every student, what do you want to become? We should not be the first in that row. If we are in the third row or fourth row, we will learn which option to copy. Right? Most of us, we will say engineers. Because why do you want to become an engineer? If somebody asks, because my grandmother has told me. This is our career option. Grandmother has asked us to become engineer. And we would have flunked very badly in mathematics and physics. Yet, grandmother has asked us to become engineer. Only when we do engineering in the third year or second year, you will realize, oh, I'm not made for engineering. After 4 years of engineering, you will take up MBA in finance. And then you will do CFA 3 levels to get one charter. Mechanical engineering ho gaya, thermodynamics, nabhi abhi charter. Then after doing MBA, you will realize you're not meant for it. You will do PhD in colonial literature. And then after that, you will realize that Upanyasams are better and you will do Pravachanam. So, here, every deity who had come there had said, we will give this boon and that boon. And finally stood Surya, the Abhimanini Devata for sun, ministry of solar energy. So he said, what boon can I give? Everything is exhausted. That is when Anjana Devi said, see, whichever school I admit my son, they say he's hyperactive and they give TC. I don't know, what is that? You have TC concept here, a transfer certificate? They sent. So please take my son into your school. Surya Deva said, see, I'm very busy. He has to learn as I walk. He has to walk along with me and learn. That is okay, my son is anyways hyperactive, he won't sit in one place. Even if you walk, he will walk along with you and learn. This way, Hanuman became a student of Surya. and learnt the 9 forms of grammar. Navavyakarana Pandita. So, Hanuman, because of his extreme energies, was once cursed by the rishis that unless and until somebody motivates him and reminds him of his energy, he will not be cognizant of his own energy. So, that is when Jambavan came and said, Hanuman, you can do. You remember that Sachin advertisement, boost is the secret of my energy. Our energy. That is how here, Jambavan motivated Hanuman. Tum kar sakte ho, Hanuman. Tum kar sakte ho. Then Hanuman went and stood above the parvatam. That hillock where he stood is called Mahendragiri. And that Mahendragiri in Tamil language is called Tirukkurungudi today. Sir, ye sab theek hai. Ye yaad rakhna ye kya hai Tirukkurungudi. Have you heard of the company called TVS? The T in TVS stands for Tirukkurungudi. Tirukkurungudi Vengarai Sundaramayangar and Sons. Tirukkurungudi is very close to Tirunelveli. What is Tirunelveli famous for? Alva. Vangalam. Kudukadam kudad. Yeah, so Tirunelveli. So very close to Tirunelveli is Tirukkurungudi. So Hanuman went and stood up the hill. So as the Vanaras motivated him, he could gather and harness that energy. As he grew, Ramayana says he grew. The stress was on the boulders and the snakes came out of the crevices. So there is so much of description given as to how Hanuman had to take off. And like a rocket that will propel, he propelled. See, Ramayana is just not about description. It is about small nuances of Shastram that it talks about. When Hanuman of sheer force propelled upwards, the shrubs and the herbs around him, they got uprooted because of the extreme force and they also went along with him to a certain distance and then came back. They fell. Gravitational pull. How did they go along with him and then come back? Valmiki gives an upama. Upama means simile, comparison. He says, like the horse who goes 7 steps outside the house to bid farewell to their guest and then come in. Look at the comparison. The plants like the horse went to a certain distance to tell bye to Hanuman and then come back. Which is a shastram that when someone comes home, you should always go out and say bye. Pogumbodhu kadava chaathin poidunga. Vaathukku vandhadhu kadhu or kaingariyam vera. So, small nuances. I go to a house and they say, you lock the door and go, sir, we have some urgent work. We are going to beta. I won't even know where to lock. Right. So, Hanuman went and the plants went and then fell. And Hanuman had to go. There were 3 obstacles. First obstacle was a mountain. So, this mountain was standing amidst or in the middle of Hanuman's sojourn like an impediment. It was actually trying to convey a certain message to Hanuman, rest in my mountain for 3 days, 2 nights, 9 only. Offer. So Hanuman said, see, I am already on a mission to see Sita. If I take, such rest, intervals, sabbaticals in the middle, it won't serve my purpose. So he hugged the mountain and said, treat my very embrace as having stayed in your mountain. And he went further. As he flew further, there was a snake, says Ramayanam, that was trying to open its mouth, trying to hint at Hanuman that I want to eat you. So Hanuman tried telling, see, pancha pancha nakaha bhakshya. For kshatriyas, 5 animals meat were allowed for consumption. Pancha pancha nakha bhakshya. 5 nailed 5 animals, like porcupine, mullam pandri. So whatever, we can't even imagine, iguana, hare, tortoise, these were meant for the consumption of the kshatriyas. And whatever were the animal products were used in different samskaras. The porcupine has needle-like structures. That is why those needles were preserved from the kshatriya families. And in the house, if the lady is pregnant, during her 8th month, there is a, today we call it baby shower. Right? In Shastram, it is called Seemantam. Because you part hair. So for the first time, the pregnant lady, with the needle of the porcupine, you part hair. parting of hair in Sanskritam is called Seemantam. Seemantam means parting. In Tamil, vahudedukkirudhu. Telugu lo em cheptaru? Madhyalo unna pradesham. You separate hair, right? That is called Seemantam in Sanskritam. That is why you do Seemantam. So you use those animal products. So Hanuman was trying to tell that snake, seeing those five animals which can be consumed, monkeys are not there. It is in that article 14F. It is in a different article. I don't come in this. I am endangered species. You should not eat me. But the snake was trying to hint that it's okay, you have to get inside my mouth. That is when Hanuman expanded. So the snake did open its mouth further. He grew further. That opened its mouth further. By the time its mouth was completely enlarged, Vayuputraha sa buddhiman, says Valmiki. In that moment he was able to think, he became very small. Sukshma roopa dhari siyahi dikhava, bikata roopa dhari lanka jarava, bhima roopa dhari asura sahare, ramachandra ke kaj savare, laya sajivan lakhan jiyaye, shri raghuvir hara shiur laye, raghupati kinhi bahut badaye, tum mam priya bharat samabhai, sahasa badana tum ro yash gabe, asa kahi shripati kantha lagabe, sanakadik brahmadi munisa, narad sharad sahit ahisa, yam kuber digpal jahante, kavi kovid kahi sake kahate, tum upkar sugriv hi kinha, Ram milaya rajapad dinha, Ram Lakshman Janaki, Ram Lakshman Janaki,
Vayuputraha sa buddhiman went inside that nagam called Surasa and emerged. That is when Surasa was trying to say that I was sent to test your skills. You have proven that a person with that presence of mind will be able to win. You will be successful. And Surasa went away. As he was about to arrive in Lanka, there was some air turbulence. Chayayam grihyamanayam chintayamasa vanaraha, says Valmiki. Hanuman got worried. Abhi kya hai? Abhi dikh raha hai runway. Iske pehle kya? So there was a demoness called Simhika. So Simhika was trying to kill Hanuman. She was the true enemy in that sense. That is when Hanuman remembered the kriti of Tyagaraja. Tyagaraja, the great classical poet of southern India who had pristine Rama Bhakti, says there are three indications or characteristic features to be a devotee of Rama. First, Romanchamane ghana kanchukamu. When you listen to Ramanama Prabhavam, it seems you should get goosebumps. Horripilation. If you are not getting, I am not doing a good job. That's all. Romanchamane ghana kanchukamu. First feature. Second, Rama Bhaktudanu Mudra Billayu. You should have the tattoo that I am Rama's devotee. Rama Bhaktudanu Mudra Billayu. Third, you should have a weapon. Sir, that is Second Amendment, right? What are you talk about? Weapon? No. You should have Rama Namam with you. Rama Namamane Varakhadgami Vi. Rama Namamane Varakhadgami Vi Rajillu Naya Tyagaraju Nike Banturi Te Kolu Viyavaya Rama Banturi Te Kolu Viyavaya Rama. Rama, Rama, Rama. So Hanuman, he took the name of Rama and killed Simhika. And about 6:37 in the evening, he stood on the sands of Lanka. As he took
the size of a cat, not the form of a cat, very small. He saw a huge trident made in cast iron stand in front of him. He looked to the top. It was the immigration officer of Lanka. Her name was Lankini. Have you got any plant products inside? Then one Bhairava came to smell. That Bhairava, Bhairavi, whoever, that will come and smell. What have you brought? Hanuman said, no, I was already intimated. In your country, plant products are not allowed. I have not brought anything. Show me your passport. In Bharata Desham, they don't issue passports for Vanaras. I thought it was visa on arrival because Lanka is visa, free visa. So why should I bring all this? And then that Lankini, her name was Lankini. She was the guardian of Lanka. She said, how dare you speak to me like that with arrogance? And she knocked him on his head. Even during his school days, he was not physically abused like this. He thought, let the world turn blind. Because they are saying, right, an eye for an eye will make the world blind. Let the world turn blind. I will do tit for tat, kuttu for kuttu. So he jumped up and he gave her a knock. This is where she was able to manage to remember something that she had forgotten for long. See, I don't know, it's a very... maybe an Indian origin thing. If you remember something and somebody wants you to tell something and you don't remember, you will hit yourself. Adva, you will hit. So, you know, I was in Bombay. I used to work. Those of you who are from Bombay may know. So I used to work in Vikroli. And I used to stay in Matunga. And during the Navaratri, families in Chembur. Chembur is one locality that comes in between. So families used to call me to recite Sundarakandam for Navaratri. I went. And that day I went slightly late. So the hosting family, I had to tell them I had to leave early. They said, no problem, you work from here itself. So I said, ma'am, I've not got my laptop. I need to log into my system. So they said, so what? We will show you that system. And I was hunting for where the system was. Finally, it was Mama's dhoti that was covering the system. Mama's veshti is a multi-purpose veshti. So they took that dhoti out and that monitor was there and I had to sit. Luck plays its own role. Providence, I would say. So the system was not working. I called that mommy, that lady of the house, and said, ma'am, the monitor isn't working. She gave one knock to that monitor and it started working. She didn't stop there. She said, idu avaramari. This is just like him, like how he too needs and deserves a knock. Even the system does. So I knew the chemistry of that house. So this Lankini, the moment she was struck by Hanuman on her head, she said, I vividly remember that I was cursed to be the Lankini of Lanka. And when I asked Brahma, when should I relinquish my position? He said, when an extraordinary Vanara comes and knocks at your head, you put down your papers and you come. She said, all the best, Hanuman. And she left. Now, immigration officer is also gone. Hanuman had to go bhavanam after bhavanam. See, I can't describe the entire Sundarakanda because Sundarakanda alone is 2,600 verses. So I'm assuming, you know, in physics books in India, you will have as discussed in the previous chapters. So I'm assuming you all know Sundarakandam. So Hanuman gets into Lanka. He goes house after house. He goes to the inner apartment, Shuddhatma. Remember, Shuddhatma in Sanskritam doesn't mean pure soul. See, Sanskritam doesn't operate the way that you want it to operate. Two words having meanings when come together don't have to give the combined meaning. What is gramam? Village. What, sir? You don't know that also? They have called you in embassy. Huh? Village. Gramam is village. Simham? Simham is lion. Gramam is village. Grama simham? Dog. Very good. It is not lion. Grama simham means dog. So somebody may introduce you, assuming you don't know Sanskritam, I am grama simha. You will feel I am the lion of that village. No, he's calling you a dog. So, janaha. What does janaha mean? People. Punya. Punya, those who have done good deeds. Punya janaha means rakshasas. So if someone says punya janaha, he's calling you a rakshasa. So shuddha atma doesn't mean pure soul. It means inner apartment. The place where the women live is called shuddhatma. So he went to the shuddhatma. He saw on the bed was reclining a man with all scars on his chest. And next to him was a beautiful lady. Hanuman thought this must be Sita. Asphotaya masa chuchumba puchham. He kissed his tail. Nananda chikrida jagau jagama stambanaroham nipapadabhuma nideshayan swam prakritim kapina. Then he realized, how will Sita be sleeping happily next to Ravana? This must not be Sita. This must be his wife, not Sita. So Hanuman commits a mistake but does course correction. See, it's a very important skill that we need to learn. It is not as if Hanuman is flawless. He commits mistakes, but he knows how to do course correction. But we have ego problem when we do a mistake. No, we will keep telling. Wo kya bata rahe the aaj? Shabari ne aisa kuch, she did not bite and give. Ye kaisa ho sakta hai? Ramanand Sagar has shown. How can Ramanand Sagar be wrong? Only Valmiki can be wrong, right? So, see, knowledge is not about acquiring what you don't know. Knowledge is also about unlearning what you have learned wrongly. Knowledge is also that. So, here, Hanuman, after having corrected himself that this cannot be Sita, her name should be Mandodari. Am I right? Is the word Mandodari or Mandodari? Mandodari. Remember, Manda means thin. Udaram means stomach, abdomen. So, she has gone to VLCC. I don't know in India if you don't know that VLCC. After keto diet, quinoa, and the artisa padalam kurututu. Melissa Kidva. So then Manda Udaram means thin hip. So it's Manda Udara Mandodari, not Mandodari. Mandodari you cannot do Vyutpatti. It's Mandodari. So after having searched for Sita, he goes inner apartment. Finally, when he's not able to spot her, he sees one place where he hasn't searched before. It is written outside. Ashoka Vatika, Lanka Main Road, Lanka. Address. So he jumps tree after tree and goes into Ashoka Vanam. Again, he is not able to spot Sita. He keeps looking left, right. First of all, will Sita be seated on the tree? He is on the tree. He is looking left, right. He could not spot her. Then he remembers, I have come in search of Jaganmata Sita. I paid my obeisances and prostrations to everybody but her. So he now does Sharanagati to Sita. Varinita vasute vitara kushalamai dehita vaka seva mohanadhame rame Pahi jagat janani, pahi mam karunaya pankhe ruhanayane, amba pahi jagat janani. He says, Mata, I surrender to you wherever you are. Please show yourself. I have very little time. I have come in the middle of the night. I have to head back to Bharata Desha, Mamma. Wherever you are, please showcase yourself. After having prostrated to her, he looks down. Exactly below his folded palms was seated Sita in the shade of Shimshupa Vriksham. So he's seeing Sita for the first time. See, first of all, Hanuman was a celibate. Naishtika Brahmachari. Boys only school. No co-ed. Not even one friend in his Facebook is a girl. He hasn't moved with a woman. He has not even seen Sita. See, he has gone on Operation Sita. But he has not seen Sita. And Rama has to say, go in search of Sita. Generally, when you go in these kidnap cases, you'll at least show one photo. Right, Hanuman, this is how Sita will look. Hanuman asked Rama, how will Sita look? Two eyes, one nose, one mouth, two ears. I think that's mami kunna irukku. So, he gave all these general identifications. So, Hanuman goes. Now he has to spot if this is Sita. See, it could be anybody else also, like how he mistook Mandodari to be Sita. This Sita could be Gita also. Right, who knows? So he had to find if this is Sita. How did he do that? That is why Ramayanam says, Tarkayamasa Siteti. See, Valmiki Ramayanam is your gateway to logical reasoning, because it is called Tarkashastra Nipunam. You know how to derive. Tarkayamasa Siteti. Through logical reasoning, Hanuman concluded this is Sita. How? Because when Sita had left Ayodhya, remember this, underline this, highlight this. Rama and Lakshmana wore the dress of tapasvis. It is called Valkalam. Valkala is the dress made from the bark of a tree. So you have to mingle in the forest with the forest colors, either green or brown. So they wore Valkalam. They lived the lives of tapasvis and they tied their hair. So for 14 years, Rama and Lakshmana did not cut their hair. 14 years. See, the beauty is, they say, aap Ramayan dekhe hain kya? Arun Govil ji, itna bada jata. See, jata is there. What happened to the dadi? See, will you go to the barber shop there somewhere in the forest, get alone your dadi trimmed and come? You can't do that, because in Pattabhishekam, Bharata arranges for a barber. The moment Rama enters Ayodhya, Shmashru Vardhanaha, says Ramayanam. Shmashru is mustache. Shmashru Vardhanaha means barber. So barber attends to Rama and Lakshmana after 14 years, where they chop the dadi, the mustache. Now in one movie they showed that Rama had mustache. You cannot have mustache alone. That is another problem in Shastram. You cannot have that. So he had to cut, the jata was cut. So for 14 years, Rama took a vow that he will not do any beautification to himself. So he asks Lakshmana to bring the milk of a banyan tree. It's called Nyagrodha Kshiram. So with that he ties his jata. It is like that set wet you get these days, right? Your hair will not fly. So that set wet is Nyagrodha Kshiram. So Rama and Lakshmana were with beard, mustache, jata. Whereas Sita did not go in Valkalam. Dasharatha tells Lakshmana, my daughter-in-law should not live the life of a tapasvini. She is my daughter-in-law. She is the daughter of Janaka. My wretched wife might have sent my son to the forest. She is volunteering to go to the forest. So Lakshmana, for 14 years, whatever silk clothes and ornaments are required for your sister-in-law, carry them along. So Sita in the forest wore proper Kanchipuram silk, rettapettu, mountain border, butta, rudraksham, gandaberunda motif, Ganga Jamuna. She wore that. She wore matching jewelry. One day terracotta. Everything she matched. So Sita was wearing proper silk. Now when Sita was abducted, there is a clear description given by Vedanta Deshika of the 13th century. He says, Vedodanvad vibhajanavidav vamshajam vishvamurtehe taddakulankamurtav. When she was kidnapped. See, in kidnap cases, when you do FIR, they will ask, what was that person wearing? Sim first question. I don't know, when we used to have only half an hour news in 1980s and 90s, I'm sure elderly people will be able to relate. Only half an hour news. Today, 24/7, 21 channels are there for news. Same news, breaking news, to be broken news, already broken news, to be broken. In all tenses, you will have news. So there used to be only half an hour news. Between 8 and 8:30, one news reader used to come and say, Aaj ka samachar. And then finally, they will tell about that weather report. In Tamil, there used to be one person called Ramanan. Avikaraya Shuddhaya Nityaya Paramatmane. 45 years, he only said that weather report. Accompanied with or without thunder showers. From light rain to heavy rain. Either it can be scattered or it can be pointed. It may or may not rain. He will say and go. That even I will tell. இங்கு மங்குமாக அல்லது ஆங்காங்கே இடியுடன் கூடியோ கூடாமலோ பெய்யலாம் பெய்யாமலும் இருக்கலாம் அது நானே சொல்லிவிடுவேன் இல்லையா அது இது ஸோ தேர் வில் பி அ வெதர் ரிப்போர்ட் சிமிலர்லி ஹியர் சீதா ஷி வாஸ் வேரிங் தட் சில்க் வென் ஷி வாஸ் கிட்னாப்ட் தட் டே பை ராவணா ஷி வாஸ் வேரிங் அ சில்க் வித் த பார்டர் ஆஃப் ஹம்சா. A mystic bird, you may be wondering, sir. Was silk there in those days? Kalidasa says in Kumara Sambhavam, Chinam Shukaihi Uddharata. When the flag was fluttering, it was as soft as Chinam Shukaihi, the silk of China, he says. In Udyoga Parva of Mahabharatam, when Duryodhana was accompanied by many armies, there is a mention of Chinam. China's army came and helped Duryodhana in Udyoga Parva. There is a mention. So it is not as if we were in our own cocoon and we didn't know about the geography and the topography of other places. So when she was kidnapped, there was this motive of Hamsam. Taddakulanka Murtau. So when she was kidnapped, she tore a part of her pallu. You know pallu? So, this pallu portion carries the grandeur of your sari. She tore that pallu and she put some of her jewelry and scattered them some on the ground. This silk piece and jewelry are collected by the vanaras of Kishkindha and they are produced to Rama. And Rama is asked to check if this is the jewelry of Sita. Rama has been crying all these days, so his eyes are swollen. He's not able to have clarity in his eyes. He vaguely identifies them to be Sita, but he wants to be doubly sure. So he calls Lakshmana. Lakshmana, you check and tell whether this is of your babis. So that is when Lakshmana says, Naham janami keyure, naham janami kundale, nupuretva bhijanami nityam padabhi vandanat Rama. I cannot recognize those ornaments which are to be worn in the hand, in the arms, in the choker, nothing. Then what are you able to recognize, Lakshmana? Nupuretva bhijanami. I can recognize only the anklet that she wore. How that alone? Because Nityam Padabhi Vandanat, every day I used to fall at her feet because she was my mother. And every day I used to notice that Nopuram. So, when Hanuman goes and sits atop the Shimshupa Vriksham and looks at Sita, that piece of cloth, silk cloth, was missing here. Which means, this is her sari. Because if the pallu is here, she couldn't have come to some designer here. And said, ye thoda chala gaya. Ab dusra ek silva do mere liye. Koi, who will be there? Neither will Biba be there, nor will, nobody will be there. No Paisley, no Biba, no Shilpi, nobody will be there. Even Savyasachi will not be there. Savyasachi will come only in Mahabharatam. Because remember, Arjuna was called Savyasachi. Because he was ambidextrous. Savyasacham means you can use both your hands. So in Bengal, va becomes birth. That is why he is called Sabyasachi. Right. So here, that piece of cloth was missing and whatever ornaments she had thrown, those ornaments were not there. Only the remaining were there. Tarkayamasa Siteti. He understood this must be Sita. Now he has already seen Rama. Now he is seeing Sita. Till he was with Rama, he was wondering. He was an Aishtika Brahmachari. Rama was crying, right, Sita? Kitaro. He was crying. So Hanuman was wondering. He didn't say it. Why is this man crying after Sita? Chali gai to chali gai. Ho gaya so ho gaya. Kya kar sakte hain? But he didn't say it. He was very courteous. You know, he didn't want to showcase that feeling of his. But he was wondering, why is this man crying and lamenting over Sita's loss? Now he sees Sita. Opinion completely changes. If, despite having lost her, if Rama is managing to survive, he must be a hard-hearted man. Complete opinion change. He must be dead by now. Anybody will be dead by having such kind of a wife who's missing. How is he managing to survive? Now, after having seen Rama, now seeing Sita, he's making a comparison between the husband and wife, whether they are fit for each other. What is a jodi making? So there's a beautiful verse. Tulya Shila Vayo Vrittam, Tulya Abhijana Lakshanam, Raghavor Hati Vaidehim, Tanchayam Asite Kshana. So he compares the husband and wife. In various parameters, he says they are a good match. Tulya Shila in qualities. Just by looking at her demeanor, he is able to gauge that she is the exact match for Rama. Tulya Shila Vayo Vayas. Age. Oh, I think their age also quite matches. Two of them get into the lift. Namaskaram, Mama. Punna, are you your wife, sir? It shouldn't look as if they are like, father and daughter.
You should look at husband and wife.
Tulya Shilavayo Vrittam, their characteristics. Tulya Abhijana Lakshanam, Abhijanam.
So whenever, till in the recent past, there used to be, now it's an extinct phenomenon, it used to be called arranged marriage. It used to exist long ago. Actually, my grandparents brought me up. My parents were in another city for some time. I was under the guardianship of my grandparents. I'll tell you this, that was my golden period of my life. Because grandparents are mature parents. So, they were so loving and so caring. My grandmother was extremely pretty. Very, very beautiful. And my grandfather was okay. So, I remember having asked such a blunt and an immature question to my grandmother while I was in class 3. Party, how did you marry this tata? I asked. My grandmother was a very jolly person. She used to say, it's okay. Da. See, I had 5 more sisters who were after me waiting in the line to get married. I had no choice to pick and choose who is the best. My father literally told me, I found a groom for you. You have to close your eyes and marry. So I followed what he said. I closed my eyes and kanna moodi inda kalyanam pannikona pannindutten appo romba mosam appo dhaan therinjathu. So later I realized the repercussions of my decision, but now I have a grandson like you. So I said, I have a lot of grandfather in me, don't worry, party. So here, how were they looking? Tulya Abhijana Lakshanam, their family backgrounds matched. Raghavor Hati Vaidehim, Hanuman says, for that Raghava, that Raghukulodbhuta Rama, Vaidehim, this Sita is the match. For this Sita, Rama is the match. He should conclude there. But Hanuman has changed party now. It is the time. Right, now the right time to change. So he said, I've changed party. What party he has come to? He has come to Sita's party. He was earlier in Rama's party. He has said, now I have come to Sita's party. How do we know that? The last words Valmiki confirms. Tanchayam asitekshana. To the beautiful mercy-laden eyes of Sita, Rama is a match in good demeanor, quality and everything. Which means in every attribute, Rama and Sita are a match except the eyes. Sita wins Rama over in her eyes, because eyes are a very powerful tool. In Shastram, if you remember, I don't know how many of your grandmothers would have said, after you go to an event and come, they will take drishti. It's called Nazar Utarna, right? They'll say, no, somebody would have cast evil eyes on you. There may be nothing to cast evil eyes on us. But still, you know, the grandmother will feel, no, drishti potu pada raja, ni eppadi irukka therimo raja maari irukka, enda ur raja patti? In Tamil Nadu, they're saying, vaippe illa raja. That Raja, va? Enda Raja? So, which eyes? So, Tanchayam Asitekshana. See, eyes. We generally think communication has to be only oral. Not necessary. It is body language which can communicate. When I, you know, music concerts are different. They'll switch off the lights and the singer will keep on singing. They'll close their eyes. Lectures can't be like that. I have to keep looking at you. I should not give you even that 1 second to scratch your nose as well. I should just keep looking every side. Right? And if you're bored, I should know from your body language. I should keep looking at how your facial expressions are. How many of you are listening? How many of you went out? How many of you came in? What time you came? What time you went out? Everything I have to notice. Imagine you've got another party to attend. Probably 2 of them are seated. They'll say, I should observe who all asked to go, and tomorrow when they come, I should, if they say the lecture was too good, then I should say, no, 8:30 you left, no. I should say. So, it's all about noticing everything, but you should act as if you have not noticed anything. Tanchayam asitekshana. So, Hanuman was able to compare. Then, Ravana comes and tells Sita, Sita, in 1.5 months time, if you don't marry me, you will be eaten. See, there was a concept in certain Rakshasa communities to consume human flesh. We have, you know, what is a cannibal, sir? We have reminders. Very rarely you'll get such Rakshasas like Tataka. Tataka, whom Rama killed. She was killed because she used to eat the fetuses. So, all this practice was there. So he says, if you don't marry me, I will eat you. What kind of
dhamki is this? So that is when he tells all the demonesses there, try to torment her and coax her to get me married. Ekakshi meka karni. So as Ravana leaves that place, the Rakshasis come to torment her. Trijata. She is believed to be the daughter of Vibhishana. There is no reference in Ramayana that she is the daughter. It's a belief. She was good. Her father was good. So we believe that the good father must have produced a good daughter. Not always true of this equation. But she had so much of hair that she used to plait three. See, you ekaveni, you take your hair, distribute it into three branches, then put one like this, one like this, one like this, three branches. It is called triveni. Triveni means one plait. So she used to have three plaits. So that was, if you go to some parts of Africa today, you see some of the women do having many, many jatas, right? That is a concept that was prominent even among Paulastyas. So she used to have three plaits. So she was called Trijata. So Trijata came and said, don't torment this Sita. I just dreamt of Ravana, our king, being completely tonsured, drenched in oil, and seated on a donkey and going in the southern direction. Because in Shastram, anything down south, anything that goes southwards, not the direction itself, going southwards means gives loss. That is why in stock market also you say, right, when something, it goes southwards, means there is loss. So, that very moment, as he said, Trijata, she described her dream. And she said, don't torment Sita. And they all went back to sleep. But Sita found no message or messenger from Rama. So what she does is she ties herself to the hair and she wants to hang herself from the tree. Suicide number two. I told already one suicide at 6:55. You remember Hanuman and the other monkeys wanted to come 6:55 today? This year. Idam sthanam. But New Zealand deshe, Uttara dvipe, Tasya Rajadhani, Wellington Mahanagare, Bharata Utsava Madhye, Samipe, Idam Stotravaniti, Shrutavaniti. So you have already heard. So here down at that place, she wanted to commit suicide. Now imagine Hanuman's position. He has flown so much of distance, and if he is now witness to this suicide, that will become a criminal case also. He has to go to the court. He has to tell Sita Mata, mat karo. If Hanuman speaks in pure Sanskritam and Sita listens to it, she'll get cardiac arrest. Because a vanara in the middle of the night speaking in flawless Sanskritam will give her more jittery. So what will she do? So Hanuman had to stop her from committing suicide. She's about to hang herself. He started singing. Saguna Brahma Parat Pararam Kalatmaka Parameshwara Ram Shesha Talpa Sukha Nidruta Ram Brahmadyamara Prarthita Ram Chanda Kirana Kula Mandana Ram Shrimaddasharatha Nandana Ram Kausalya Sukha Vardhana Ram Vishwamitra Priyadhana Ram Ghorataataka Ghataka Ram Mari Chadrini Pataka Ram Kaushika Makha Samrakshaka Ram Srimadahalyodharaka Ram Gautama Muni Sampujita Ram Sura Muni Varagana Samstuta Ram Navita Dhavita Mrudupada Ram Mithila Purajana Mohakaram Videha Manasaranjakaram Triambaka Karmuka Bhanjakaram Sitarpita Varamalikaram Kritavaivahika Kautukaram Bhargava Darpa Vinashakaram Srimadayodhya Palakaram Rama Rama Jaya Raja Ram Rama Rama Jaya Sita Ram Rama Rama Jaya Rama Rama Jaya Sita Ram. Early in the morning between 3 and 4 a.m. when everyone was sound asleep and she was in a very, very tiresome position to even end her life, she's listening to the Namam of Rama. She was wondering, where is this 93.4 FM? This is prohibited in Lanka. How come I hearing Rama Namam? And she slowly looked up from where the sound was emanating, and Hanuman looked down. As he looked down and Sita looked up, he jumped in front of Sita and said, Mata, shh, I am the messenger of Rama. Rama Chandra Syada Soham.
Sita is very careful. She says, so, show me your Aadhaar card. Aadhaar dikhao. Tum, your Ram's Sishya, Duta, show me.
Because she knew she did not ask Ravana before. She had lessons from the past. Hanuman said, Mata, for Kishkindha people alone, no Aadhaar is issued. Then how do I believe you have come from Rama? You ask questions, Mata. What is Rama's height? This is her question in Valmiki Ramayana. Hanuman says 8 feet, dvichatushta, 8 feet. That's the number given in Valmiki Ramayana, 8 feet. She asks, describe his eyes. Hanuman says, Mata, people generally say I'm a well-spoken person, I'm an eloquent person. But you have given me an arduous task of describing his eyes. If I compare his opened eyes to the petals of a newly blossomed lotus, the lily flowers come and fight with me as to why I did not compare his eyes with the lilies. His eyes are beyond comparison. Vachama gochara mahima virajite. You can't describe. See, when you eat the best of the sweets, somebody asks you, how was it? Excellent. You may be the master of all words. Your vocabulary can be second to none. You will be a nulli secundus. But when you reach the heights of ecstasy and something which is a delight, you will fall short of words. He said, Mata, how can I describe his eyes? She said, correct answer. So question after question, then she says, has he sent anything with you as a reminder? He then slowly takes that ring and gives it to her. Remember, every act of Hanuman is well thought. See, generally, how should Sita take? Hanuman should throw the ring like this. Sita should take it like this. But when you take it like this, it's called Bhiksha Mudra. Only when you seek alms, you'll do this. A mother should never ask her children, give me money. We should never keep our parents in that position. You should give. You should never make them ask. Parents should never say, I don't have money, please give me. So Hanuman knew this. So instead of him giving it like this and Sita taking it like this, he placed the ring on his very palm and Sita took it. As she took it, Valmiki says, Grihitva prekshamanasa bhartukkara vibhushanam bhartaram iva samprapta janaki mudita abhavat. How impressed or how happy or how excited was she when she received the ring? The poet says, even if by chance Rama was next to the ring, she will still choose the ring and not Rama. She was that happy with the ring, it seems. Why? To which the commentator says in a commentary called Bhushanam, Govindaraja states, because this was the ring gifted to Rama by Sita's father. That is why in the metal jammer, when it detected, Kaikeyi had no right to take that ring. Else Rama gave every jewelry to Kaikeyi, right? Why didn't he give this? Because it was gifted by his father-in-law. Kaikeyi had no jurisdiction over it. So he was wearing that ring. So Sita was thinking, my father gave two things in marriage. One, the ring. Second, me. This man has lost me. At least he has the ring. Idhaal vichin rikayadu. Ilya, enniyum dolachuttu nina mari, enniyum dolachuttu nikka poorudu. Adhaal, modaramavu vichin rikare. Grihitva prekshamanasa bhartukkara vibhushanam bhartaramiva samprapta janaki mudita bhavat. Then she takes the ring, she gives identity, she gives her gem-studded hair clip. What is it called? Chudamani. She gives the chudamani. Generally, we get it in Pondi Bazaar. So she gave the chudamani to Hanuman and said, you take this, Hanuman. And she gives a few incidents like Kakasura Vrittantam. And then she blesses him. Ashta Siddhi Navanidhi Kedata Asavaradina Janaki Mata Ram Rasayan Tumhare Pasa Sadaraho Raghupati Kedasa. She blesses him. Then Hanuman says, Mata, don't wait for Rama to come. You sit behind me. I'll put seat belt. I'll take you from here. There will be many islands. Tonga Island, this island, that island. I'll give you one rest. Fiji will come. You'll get Vadathand also there. Frozen. You'll get Okra there. I'll take you from one island to the other. I'll take you. Don't wait for Rama to come. Bahut din ho jayega, Mata. Delay bahut ho jayega. She said, no. Nahi, Hanuman. Main nahi tumhare saath nahi. I said, kyun, Mata? Then what will people speak? What will media report? What will Arnab say? Nation wants to know, he will say. 10 people will come and shout together. Wow, kaise kya ho sakta hai? So Hanuman said, Mata, what will people say? I am like your son. You are my mother. In Malleshwaram, Vesmambalam, mothers go behind their sons in a scooty. So what? I will. You sit behind me and come. Nahi, Hanuman. If you take me to Bharata Desham, tomorrow some person like Dushyant will come to the Indian embassy in Wellington and say, from Bharata Desham, Ravana took Sita all the way to Lanka. And Hanuman brought Sita from Lanka to India. What was Rama doing watching the match? Kya kar rahe the? Dandamu pette nurako dandapani judara uruvaru vidhivaru. Tyagaraja Sahityam. Dandamu pette nura kodandapani judara. In Tamil, in the Tamil language, dandam has two meanings. Dandam means stick. Dandam means waste. Unga aathukar dandam. In the kuchi, adu dandam. So, what is the use of having the name Ikshvaku Kula Tilaka? Ramachandrudu, what is he doing? He just watched the match of kidnapping. No, let him come and protect me. What is he there for? He says, he keeps boasting that he has learnt all Astra Shastram from Vasishta and Vishwamitra. Let him make use of it. And then Hanuman goes. Finally, he's taken to the court of Ravana. They say, you have to kill this Vanara. He says, no, as per 1964 Geneva Convention, you cannot kill, you can only give back. So that is when they say we have to punish him. So the tail of a monkey is its most prestigious part. So all hordes of cloth are tied to the tail, dipped in ghee. You're all very good in dairy products here. So in your ghee, New Zealand ghee. And fire was attached to that particular tail. Hanuman was a social media person. Jo bhi mila hai, share. Share karo. So he started sharing it with all the houses, though leaving away those houses which were infested with young, very young, old, good people. So the remaining houses were all burnt. And then he went back. Now, when he was to fly back, because before the morning sun could rise, he had to come back to Bharata Desham. Now, the remaining Vanaras were very worried. Jambavan, ye kya hua? What is the result? Hanuman nahi aaye hai. When they asked this question, Valmiki says, there was a thunderous noise of Hanuman. They have not seen Hanuman. There was only a noise. Jambavan immediately said, Vanaras, Hanuman has seen Sita. Vanaras asked, Abhi tak Hanuman hi nahi aaye hai. How do you conclude just from the tone that Hanuman has seen? Jambavan says, in certain cases, the tone and tenor is enough to determine the outcome of an incident. The child goes for an entrance exam. After giving that entrance exam, she comes inside. Mother is asking, well, how did it go? Well, that means you have to pay the fees again. well, na ena kanna rupaya chudla. Yeah. So, you attend one discourse and go. Some of you may have listened to my discourses before. Some of you may have not listened and may not want to also. So, you have listened to this discourse. You go back home. I just tried calling you. Where were you? I had been to a discourse. How was it? Okay. Right. So, this okay and all that will determine the outcome of any lecture, right? So, Hanuman gave a thunderous noise which was akin to the victory that he has sensed and tasted. So, Hanuman came. Now he should have taken all the Vanaras and rushed towards Kishkindha, which is Karnataka. But he doesn't go. He goes to a vineyard. that vineyard was bought as an investment property by Sugriva. So there the wine, grape juice was fermented. So the caretaker was Sugriva's own uncle called as Dadhimukha. So this fermented juice was given. And as these vanaras consumed, now they all started dancing.
Gayanti kechit, pranamanti kechit, nityanti kechit, prasahanti kechit. Their excitement, now it was coming down because of that fermented grape juice. Hanuman did not drink. He took all these vanaras after that night to Kishkindha.
Meanwhile, that caretaker of that vineyard who was Sugriva's uncle called Dadhimukha, he was bruised because of all these vanaras, and he goes and tells Sugriva, look at my body, Sugriva. Look at me, what Hanuman and the other monkeys have done to my body. Sugriva sees his uncle's physical state and turns towards Rama and says, Hanuman has seen Sita.
Rama was confused. Your uncle is bruised.
What connection does it have with Hanuman seeing Sita? He says, without reason, Hanuman will not party.
So, there will be some reason.
So, he has seen. Now, Hanuman comes. See, if we were in Hanuman's position, just imagine for a moment we are in Hanuman's position. We have seen Sita. And we are going and meeting Rama. Rama asks, what happened?
Oh, I'll tell you, Rama. From here I started, okay?
I went to south of India, very next to Tirunelveli. It is Tirukkurumudi. I went there. And from there I took, you know, I came across Mainakam, the mountain, Surasa, the snake, and Nagamata, Simhika, the real demoness. I managed to win all the three, Rama. I will give such a huge description. By the time I arrive, if I have seen Sita or not, Rama will be tired. So Hanuman was just not a person good at narrating. He knew what to communicate and how. He says, Drishta Sita. I have seen Sita. That's all. Two words. There is a verb. There is an object. That's all. I saw Sita, and that I is also not there because there were not 10 people who went. Only Hanuman had gone. So that I is redundant. Sita is important. More than Sita, the verb is important. Remember, in S plus V plus O, we have the sentence pattern, right? Subject, predicate, verb, object, indirect object, direct object. Rennacharya, Martinacharya have taught to us, right? So in this S plus V plus O formation, you have to precede a verb before the subject or the object if the verb is of more priority. Because if Hanuman had gone in search of four women, Sita, Gita, Vani, Rani, and he saw only Sita and not the other three women, then you should say Sita was seen, which means Gita was not seen. But here the person of search is only one, Sita. So there is only one option, to see or not to see. So he has seen Sita. So see, which becomes a past participle, saw, Drishta, becomes more important than the subject. So Drishta Sita Panikala Vari Jampola. Arunachala Kavi of the 17th century in the Tamil language says, Panikala Vari Jampola Nirankushi Pagaloru Yugamaga Kalitale Prayasi Ninetange Ravanan Annanvara Chi Chi Nillada Yendre Yesi Tanita Tanbuyi Tanai Tanvida Magarasi Sarum Pode Karnum Samayami Devasi Inita Madam Shayalaga Dendridar Pesi Rama 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 Yendredir Pesi Kanden 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 Sitaye Kanden Raghava Andarum Kanada Lanka Puriyil அரவிந்த வேதவை தர வந்த மாதவை கண்டேன். சோ ஹனு ராமா, யூனோ, ஆஃப்டர் சச் அ லாங் டைம் ஹீஸ் ஹியரிங் அ பீஸ் ஆஃப் பாசிட்டிவ் நியூஸ் தட் சீதா இஸ் அலைவ். ஷீ இஸ் இன் லங்கா. ஷீ இஸ் வெயிட்டிங் ஃபார் ராமாஸ் அரைவல். யூனோ, சம் ஆஃப் யூ மே பி வண்டரிங், ஐ எம் ஜஸ்ட் கோயிங் சைட் ட்ராக், why is he calling Rama, Rama, Rama? Isn't it Ram? Isn't it Lakshman? Why Rama, Lakshmana? Because these are all Sanskritam based words. The root is Adharam is Sanskritam. In Sanskritam, the language, you have to end the word with the sound of the last letter. This is Panini's grammar. For example, ra,
ra,
ri,
ri,
ru, ru. You've got the rakarantam. So in that, ra is the first letter. Ra, ma,
ma,
mi, mi, you say. So it is first letter ma, ra, ma, that a sound should come. This is the rule of Sanskritam. But in the south of India, there is a mistake where they add an extra a, making it Rama,
Krishna.
See, Krishna makes it Strilingam. In Mahabharatam, Draupadi was called Krishna. Throughout in Mahabharatam, if you come across Draupadi's passages, she'll be called Krishna. So if technically we were to time travel and live in the times of Mahabharata and we say Krishna, then Draupadi will come running. So if it is, you have to call the Lord, you have to say Krishna, na, a sound should come, not na, Krishna, Krishna, Krishna is Draupadi, Krishna is Krishna, whom we know. On the other hand, in the north of India, there's a small mistake. In Hindi, which comes from a base of Prakritam, Maithili, Bhojpuri and Haryanvi. So these are the roots. Then you've got Braj and Avadhi. So all this gives rise to Hindi as a language. In Hindi, you though the letter may be like that of Devanagari, the grammar is different from Sanskritam. So in Hindi, you should not end the word with the sound of the last object. You have to complete it halfway before. So it's not Rama, it's Ram. It's not Krishna, it's Krishna. It's not Govinda, it's Govind. It's not Padmanabha, it's Padmanab. But in Hindi, it's okay. But you're using the word of Sanskritam, right? You're not using a Hindi word. So it's Sanskritam. So in Sanskritam, you should neither say Govinda or Govind. You should say Govinda. That a sound should come. Then only it will determine the lingam of that word. Now let me get back. Now Rama had to tell Hanuman, Hanuman, you have done a great job. What did he have? Generally, you arrange a party, you have to give return gift. So what did Rama have to give? He said, Hanuman, come here. The Vanaras were watching. TV channels were reporting. Kuch dene wale hain. Dekhte hain ki kya dete hain. Rama said, I have nothing to give, Hanuman. I can just give you one thing. Come here. Hanuman went close with all modesty and humility. Apara para vara parikha parivrita parapura parasrita davadahana javana pavana bhava kapivara parishvanga bhavita sarva swadana. He gave a heartfelt embrace to Hanuman and said, this is what I can give. Hanuman started shedding tears. What more do I need, Rama? What more do I require besides this heartfelt embrace? And then the Setu Bandharam was over. Vibhishana Sharanagati was over. They all went to Lanka. There was a huge battle fought for 7 days with Ravana, Kumbhakarna, Indrajit, Malyavan. And Hanuman had to go bring four plants. Sandhana Karani, Vishalya Karani, Mrita Sanjeevani and Sanjeevani. Four names. You know, you have this binomial nomenclature. Chlorophytum, Buriviliyanum, Periplaneta, Americana, Rana, Hexa, Dactyla. Now the biologist, botanist came and said, I need four plants and gave. And Hanuman was a commerce student. So he didn't know botany. Then he went there. He was confused between all the four plants. So he said, let me take the entire place itself. Let him select whatever plants he wants. And twice he came. Remember, two times he flies with the mountain. He goes and comes. And then finally, after the yuddham was over, Hanuman was told by Rama to go and inform Sita that there is victory in the war. When Hanuman goes, he tells Mata, Rama has won the war. Sita tells, that day when I was about to commit suicide, it was you who came and stopped me and gave me life. Today when I'm worried about the outcome of the war, it is you who comes and gives me the news of victory. Hanuman, what do I give you in return? Can I keep my head at your feet? This is a shlokam in Yuddhakandam. For which Hanuman says, Mata, never, never. Hanuman was very much aware of Tamil Nadu politics. He said, everybody can fall at Amma's feet. Amma will fall at nobody's feet. So, you should not fall. And then they all went to Ayodhya. And in Ayodhya, every devata had come to attend Ramapatta Abhishekam, which we will be discussing tomorrow. Except
Indra. Indra had sent through DHL courier one chain, some necklace he got, Kushal's necklace or something, and he sent. So this was given to Rama. Rama said, I'm already decked with so much of jewelry. He gave it to Sita. Sita said, see, I don't think I can take so much. This already so much. And she wanted to give to somebody whom she values the most. She gave it to Hanuman. So now we have one tale where he broke and saw in that pearl all that is not there in Ramayana. That is there in director's screenplay. So he took that necklace and put it around him. So Hanuman, in fact, is so powerful and such a sign of victory that he is placed in the flag when Arjuna fights the Kauravas, Kapidvajaha. So his presence is just not in the three kandams, Kishkindha, Sundara, Yuddha kandam of Ramayanam. He is present even when Bhagavad Gita is delivered by Krishna. Kapidvajaha in Saugandhika Parvam also he comes. So Hanuman remains one of the unchallenged, unsurpassed, priceless patrams of Sanatana Dharma. And being a devout, a fervent devotee to the Divya Dampati of Rama and Sita, he also brings together the message of intelligence coupled with logical reasoning, coupled with humility and modesty, because they say vidvat and garvam go together. If a person is extremely scholarly, then alongside ego will also come. But Hanuman is an absolute outlier. He was the personification of the highest forms of knowledge, yet extremely humble. You can be humble with no knowledge. You can be extremely knowledgeable, but very arrogant. He was extremely knowledgeable and yet humble. So he is a combination of the best of the worlds, and his devotion to Rama and Sita knows no bounds. It is for this reason that every poet from the south to the north, they have compared Hanuman's devotion second to none. So that Hanuman's greatness was told by me today. So I have to thank our High Commission here, Her Excellency Miss Neeta Bhushan Ji, and then Mukesh Ghia Ji, then Durga Das Ji, and Manoj Sahu Ji, because it's important we carry the message of our civilization out aloud in a very acceptable fashion. See, for a very long time, we have bequeathed certain attributes of our civilization, because, you know, our civilization has always tried to teach us humility. Take the example of your own grandmothers who were excellent cooks. You go to any house, they'll say, my grandmother was an excellent cook. Any Gujarati speaking Astikas here? So while I used to live in Bombay, in Ghatkopar and Cheddar stores, we used to get a dish called undhiyo. It's very tasty. It's generally made during a certain period. So undhiyo. And listening to the way it is made, you wouldn't want to make. It's a very tedious dish. And it's super tasty. You will get Vaikuntha Anubhavam when you have it. But when you go ask the person, wow, this is made so well. How did you make it? Rightfully, we would expect a half an hour reply. The grandmother will say, kuch nahi yaar, aise kar diya. So much of hard work has gone into it. It is so delicious. But they just wish it away, stating that it was done so simply. So that humility, that modesty is always there in us. But the world may not always respect our humility. So it's okay to be pompous and grandiloquent in certain occasions where we speak about our dharma and civilization. Unless and until we come out in the open and speak about our scriptures and always remain humble in our own bubbles and cocoons, the world may not realize. See, for example, while I was in Detroit, one of my host's son, he was in the university and he made pancakes for me. And that pancake was, that too, you get that ready-made mixture. You have to just mix it and put it. You know, I wanted to encourage that boy and said, it's a nice pancake. How did you make it? I was expecting one-line reply. He said, I went to the store. And I got that packet. From that packet, he began how he cut that packet using a pair of scissors and then how he put it into that bowl and then added some water and then the pan was taken and then he had to light the gas stuff and, you know, he had to take the ladle and then he had to turn it around. My goodness, for undhiyo, that grandmother says, for 2 days job, she says, kuch nahi. For that pancake, he's explaining for half an hour. That is when I thought, we are excellent at content but very bad at marketing. So I'm sure the High Commission, out of sheer benevolence and respect for the civilization in this beautiful country of New Zealand, in its capital Wellington, has made this possible to give such a beautiful premises to us for me to speak on such a solemn occasion, on such cherished topic called as Hanuman, to such an august gathering. Everything is Sundaram here as well. The country is Sundaram, you are Sundara. So the message is also beautiful of Hanuman. So they have given us the space. I'm extremely thankful to every Astika who has given us the space and who has attended. And of course, I'm very thankful to my hosts, my hosting organization, the Venkateshwara Swami Temple in Wellington, which is shaping up well. And I'm sure the next time when I come, by the grace of Arvars and Acharyas, we will surely have a temple with all your cooperation. Because in Sanatana Dharma, we have two things, Pramanam and Prameyam. Pramanam is the scripture that gives us knowledge. And whoever is denoted by the scripture is called Prameyam. So Pramanam is the book with us. Prameyam is the temple in front of us. Both are equally important. Because temple is just not a place of worship. In Sanatana Dharma, it also becomes an amalgamation of culture. You sing, you dance, you paint, you recite, you speak. So many activities can happen in a temple. So a temple becomes a fulcrum of cultural activities in Sanatana Dharma. So the Pramanam, Ramayanam is there for us. Prameyam is Rama Venkateshwara Swami for us. So I'm sure this temple is going to come up in a very big way. So all of you, whoever has not contributed, make your yatha shakti, your contribution to this temple. I'm sure it will be a grand temple in this beautiful part of this world, in the Dakshinayanam, in the southern hemisphere. And as said, tomorrow is my second lecture. So there are only two lectures in Wellington. Today is day one, tomorrow is day two. And tomorrow I shall be speaking on Rama and Rama Janma Bhumi between around the same timings in a different venue. Those of you who know of the venue, no problem. Those of you who wish to attend, who think that not bad, chal sakta, chalega. So you can come tomorrow. That chalega, you can make that chalega tomorrow also. So two chalegas, you know, you should not keep it ekam, dve. Dvayam. So two chalegas, chalega one, chalega two. So chalega one is over, chalega two will come tomorrow. So please, that is also open to all. Please bring more astikas here. Tell them that he does speak the Indian accent of English, but it's quite comprehensible. And not, in Tamil we call it purukkabul. So please do bring, you know, the language chosen is English. Though I'm from Bangalore, I speak Tamil and I speak Kannada. The language chosen, the medium of communication is English, because we want to get Bharatiyas and Astikas of all languages. Just not one particular, let's not get very regional. Let's think big. We want people from all languages to participate, and it is Rama Janma Bhumi tomorrow. So a south of India person is talking about temple in the north of India. That is India for us. That's unity for us. So it will be my saubhagyam to speak about Rama Janma Bhumi and Rama and Rama Pattabhishekam tomorrow. So please do gather. Thank you so much. I was also told that I can allocate about 5 to 10 minutes maximum for two questions. Just two questions. Any question pertaining to Dharma or our scriptures, feel free to ask. I will try giving the answer in a succinct fashion if I know of the answer. If you have a question, feel free, stand up and make your question very brief. Very brief. Yeah, please, ma'am. Namaskar. Ma'am, the Astika here has asked the question, what is significant of the number 14? Because Kaikeyi said he has to go for 14 years. There are various answers that you can find in Quora.com. But since my training is under my acharyas, my shatacharyas, six acharyas that I have of Sri Bhashyam, Gita Bhashyam, Bhagavad Vishayam, Rahasya Tresaram, Shatadushani, and so on from acharyas, we have a traditional way of quoting from the Valmiki Ramayana. I don't know, Quora.com. In the Ramayana, Manthara is the caretaker of Kaikeyi. Kaikeyi's mother was a very, you know, in Hindi bolte hain, chalu lady. She was Putana square, Shurpanaka cube. Kaikeyi's mother. So this is there in Ramayanam itself, where Sumantra mentions of this in around the 59th sargam of Valmiki Ramayanam. So this, the one who took care, nourished and nurtured Kaikeyi was the nanny. Her name was Manthara. She was a hunchback lady, Kubja. So,
what she does is she comes to Ayodhya and she gets to know that Rama is to be coronated, and then she goes to Uttishthamude. Why do you keep sleeping, Kaikeyi? Your son's future is jeopardized. That Kaushalya's son is being made the heir apparent. Immediately, Kaikeyi gives her Narayana pearls necklace. She tells, Lelo. She says, I'm extremely happy. Ramova, Bharatova, Visesham, Nopalakshaye, whether it is for Rama or Bharata, I don't see the difference. That is when Manthara takes 1.5 hours to brainwash Kaikeyi. She says, see, you are a fool. If Rama becomes the king, next who will become the king? Bharata, says Kaikeyi. No, Rama's son will become. The line will go that way. It will never reach your son. So what? My Rama will take good care of me. Why will he take good care of you? Completely mesmerized by your beauty, Dasharatha has overlooked Kaushalya's importance. Won't Kaushalya want to make use of this opportunity to give it back to you? She will keep you in the dungeons. She gives about 20 shlokas. There are 5 sargas. So there is a conversation back and forth. Finally, Kaikeyi is completely brainwashed. She says, okay, I agree. What should I do now? 2 boons you remember you once said Dasharatha granted you, and you foolish lady, it seems you didn't know what to ask. Huh, yes. Have you asked? No. Ask that now. What should I ask? Ask that Bharata should become the heir apparent. Okay, emoticon. Deal done. Ho gaya. Next boon. Ask that Rama should go to the forest. Why should he go? Fool. When Rama is going to the forest, Sita will be left in the city. She won't go to the forest. Because the original plan was only Rama had to go. If Rama goes to the forest, in the forest you cannot have, generally you're not allowed to have a physical relationship. Because forest is meant to be pristine amidst the flora and fauna. You have to live the life of a tapasvi, like a hermit. So when he goes alone and Sita is here, by then Bharata has made the king. Along with Mandavi, he may have a son, and that son will be tutored in Vasishta's hermitage, and you can keep the succession line ready, because only after proving your mettle in the 12th age and 14th age you will be allowed to become a Yuvaraja. By the time Rama comes after 14 years, we will have plan 2 ready here. Then only Rama will produce children, and he may have daughters or sons, and then the sons will be born, then you have to train them. So it's a big line. So that 14 was to give that time period for Bharata to produce children and Rama to not produce children. So this is the explanation given in Ramayana 14. The commentator says, Govindraja says in Bhushanam, his commentary, and Maheshwara Tirtha says in Tattva Viveka. So these are the commentaries. Next question, last question. Yes, madam. Namaste.
Based on some of the qualities his mother has asked to test, when he first meets Rama and Lakshmana. Can you say something about that,
please? So, Anjana Devi had no role in this. In Ramayanam, we don't have any details of Anjana Devi, that is Hanuman's mother. But you remember today between 7 and 7:30, I spoke about a portion in Kishkindha Kandam called Bhashana Kaushalam, where Hanuman's eloquence is being praised by Rama to Lakshmana. So when Hanuman sees Rama and Lakshmana, he says, Padma Patrikshanau Virau, Jatamandala Dharinau, Anyonya Sadrushau Virau, Devaloka Dihagatau. You know what Vachanam is this in Sanskritam? This is called Dvivachanam. So in Sanskritam, you don't have Ekavachanam and Bahuvachanam. You've got Ekavachanam, Dvivachanam, Bahuvachanam. 1, 2 and more than 2. Ramaha, Ramau, Ramaha. So he says, Padma Patrekshanau, Virau, Jatamandaladarinau, Anyonya Sadrushau, Virau. So all these verses, Hanuman says, I see 2 men in front of me. 2 men who have got eyes like that of lotus. So why that lotus is mentioned is that lotus is indicative of Vishnu. Kapyasam Pundarikam Evamakshini says Chandogya Upanishad, which is a part of Samavedam. So his teacher has taught him, whoever has eyes like the lotus is Paramatma. So Hanuman, when he sees Rama's eyes, he is able to think of that lesson. Oh, this must be Paramatma. Patrekshanau Virau Jatamandala Dharinau. So in Avatara Kramam, when you live as a hermit, you have to follow the rule of Jata. Anyonya Sadrishav Virav. This man looks like Narayana and he looks like the inseparable Adisesha. Anyonya Sadrishav Virav. Inseparable. Inseparability has been mentioned in Aitareya Upanishad. Devalokadihagatau, they have come from somewhere which is a celestial abode. Coming from one place to another is called avatarati iti avataraha. Avataraha means to jump, descend. So he sees the descending process. So all these sentences, the commentator says, makes Hanuman conclude that these are the characteristics of Paramatma. And he concludes that the person who is standing opposite me is no normal human being. So this is the verse that comes. Sir, your question. So we generally say 24,000 verses of Valmiki Ramayanam, that is the Mula Pramanam. 24,000 we can arrive at only if we add Uttarakandam. So Balakandam, Ayodhya Kandam, Aranya Kandam, Kishkindha Kandam, Sundara Kandam, Yuddha Kandam, Uttarakandam. Point number one. And we have one rahasyam in Ramayanam. Rahasyam is bahyakshepaha, kalartaha, bhavabayam, sadvrittam, acharyavatta, gayatri artaha, hitamuchitaparam, tattva artham shapancha, karpanyam, sheshabhavaha, gatakavidipalam, paratantriyam tatatat, kashtakal of pratiksha, vasatipadamiti, prahuhu, ashtadashartham. There are 18 rahasyas. So, if you can all pay attention, the first letter of the first verse of the first set of 1,000 verses. First letter of the first verse of the second set of 1,000 verses. First letter of the first verse of the third set of 1,000 letters. Like this, if you take and put those words together, you'll get Gayatri Mantra. So, what is the first verse? Tapasvadhyaya niratam. What is the letter? Ta. Then sa. There will be the first letter of the next 1,001th verse. V. Tur, Va, Re, Ni, Yam, Bhargo. So you'll get the entire Gayatri Mantram. So for that Gayatri Mantram to come itself, you need those 24 letters. Third, why could there be a theory that Uttarakandam could have been added later? The possibility for the theory is a lot of the incidents in the Uttarakandam don't actually coincide with our position of Rama. How could Rama, so loving to his wife, send a wife in her first trimester in the middle of the forest? One, there was no court-martialing done, nothing was done, he just sends. Then later, a person called Shambhuka, who performs tapas, his head is cut. How can Rama do such acts? This is our prima facie, purva paksham. But all our acharyas who have commented on the Ramayanam, like Maheshwara Tirtha, Govinda Raja, Nagesha Bhatta, Shiva Sahaya, then we have Madhava Yogi and Trayambakamakhin. Six people have commented on the Ramayana. They all say that Uttarakandam is a part of the Ramayanam. Another important thing is, when Balakandam begins itself, it does not begin with Rama's young age. It begins with a context where two young boys come to Ayodhya and they sing Ramayanam in front of Rama. Rama is not cognizant that these two are his own DNA, and those two children are not aware that this is their father. They think Ramayana is about some person, they are singing, and Rama thinks these two sons of somebody. So then when these boys sing, he's enamored by the kavyam and how the poet, whoever has written this, has managed to compose it in such a captivating manner. Then later he understands that these two sons are of his. And then he goes into the Ramayanam, and when he gets inside Ramayanam, he gets to read his own young age. And that's how Balakandam begins. So it is not as if Balakandam begins with Rama's young age. It begins with Lava and Kusha. So it is like a cyclic process. You complete Uttarakandam and finish Lavakusha. Again, that Lavakusha come back in Balakandam. So it is a cyclic thing. And, you know, as Indians, generally, we are very, very used to happy endings in our movies. However be that hero, however be that heroine, they have to come together and we have to say in Tamil, Vanakkam, Shubh, Lab, and finally they'll all have to conclude. We cannot take tragic endings. You know, Malayalam movies were once upon a time detested for their tragic endings. They will never have happy endings. But Ramayanam still ends happily because Lavakusha are accepted by Rama. Rama is accepted by Sita and Lavakusha rule. But yes, husband and wife, they are not together towards the end. But that is also a part of human avataram. See, Rama, the Lord chose to be Rama to prove to the fellow humans that when you are born a human, you are a result of your own karma. You may say that I did no harm to anybody, I am so good only, I went to the lecture yesterday also, aisa kyun ho raha hai? See, attending a lecture will not give you any benefit. Remember this, I'll be very frank. You are only trying to spend those 2 hours in Ramayanam. Suddenly think all your problems will not get solved. Karma will always remain. Karma is a very, very essential component. We have to, only through sufferings we can wash away our karma. So if somebody says, ye karo, wo karo, chala jayega, the intensity may slightly reduce, but your karma will not go away completely. If we don't accept this, then Vedanta is very far. Now, in Uttarakhandam, we need to understand why Rama's... There is one reason given for that by the commentator. In Rama's Jatakam, you know, Jyotishya Shastram is an important part of Sanatana Dharma. Though the Prayaschittam need not be completely correct, but the predictions can be completely correct if they are done the right way. When Rama was born, Valmiki says, Vakpata Vinduna Saha, in Rama's Jatakam, Vakpati, Brihaspati, Guru and Indu, Chandra were in one house. When both are in one house, you have to check the 12th and the second position in the Jatakam. If there is no immediate neighbor, then there is a yogam called Kemadruma Yogam. In Kemadruma Yogam cases, there is a heavy chance for at least a long distance relationship. They won't be together. They'll be separated. There could be legal solutions for that. All this may happen. So that is why in Rama's life, though personally they had no problems, in the 14th year she was kidnapped. They came back, she got pregnant, she went to the forest. So all these things will keep coming. This is a Jyotishya Shastram ending. But all our acharyas from Adi Shankara, Ramanuja, Vedanta Deshika, Madhvacharya, Raghavendra Tirtha and the 6 commentators have unanimously said that Uttarakhandam is an integral part of Ramayanam. But yes, accepting it may be problematic to us because we are bhaktas of Sita as well. When Sita suffers, we can't take it. 1. 2, questions are also pointed only on these incidents. If you see someone having questions or criticisms or critiquing, they'll say, Ram, right? Usne wife ko chhod diya na, beech mein, wo kaisa? So we feel offended. But those questions can be tough, but Uttarakhandam is an integral part of Ramayana. There is no doubt in our Vidvat Sadas, whenever we have meetings, it is completely, unanimously decided that Uttarakhandam is a part. Maybe some poets later might have not written in the regional language, worrying about the repercussions in the society. But Valmiki was a reporter. He reported exactly what he saw. Yes, pregnant Sita was sent to the forest. Yes, Shambhuka was killed. Ho gaya. Whatever you want to think, you think. He's a reporter. He's a journalism. True journalist. True and journalism used to go well in those days. So he reported as is. So this is the answer. So thank you so much once again to all the Astikas and my hosts for having me.